Layout design with CSS, box model. So even though you can't really see it sometimes, every element is in a box, a rectangle, essentially. There are different properties for this. There's content, padding, border, and margin. So let's start with content. That's basically where all of the text or images or what have you is going to be inside of your element. Then we have padding, which is the space between the content and stuff that you have in there, like text or images. Together, these work to form the basis for your box. Next up, we have border, which is on the exterior of the padding and content. And the border can come in all sorts of fancy things like dashes or dots or solid lines. You can set the width of the line and you can set the color. You don't actually see the padding or the margin, by the way. So the border code can be written kind of shorthand style. You can write it like, you know, border color, border dash color, border dash style, border dash width, or you can do them all the same. So we have border, colon, then we set the width, then we set what style we want, in this case solid, and then we set a color. So then last but certainly not least is margin. This pushes the other content that's on the page away from this content of this element. It adds space, invisible space, outside of the content and padding and border. So the default properties of all of these things are zero, with one special caveat. Some elements are given a default value by browsers. So older versions of Internet Explorer, for instance, sometimes add some space there, and that's really annoying. But you can set these things to zero on your own to make that the appropriate response. One of the things that you can do is set the width and the height of the content. Without doing so, it will spread the content, this element, all the way across the page or until it reaches something else or it's constrained by some other box. So padding, margins, and border can be applied to all the sides or to individual sides. So if I want to do it to all sides, I would just say padding, colon, 25px, semicolon. If I want it just to be on the left side, I have it like the example here, padding dash left, and then a numerical value. The same thing is true of margins, but they have one special thing. They can be given a negative value. So instead of pushing things away, they pull them closer. So if you have margin right of 10 pixels, it will push things away from it by 10 pixels. If you have a margin right of negative 10 pixels, it will pull things closer. One important thing to keep in mind is that with padding, border, and margin, adding these things on add to the total amount of the space that you're going to take up, but they don't affect the amount of space within the content. What I mean is, if you want to calculate the total width of something, you will take 2 times the margin plus 2 times the padding plus the width of the content area. To calculate the total height of whatever it is that you're building, you would take 2 times the margin, 2 times the padding, and then also add in the height of the content area. So let's look at an example. Here we have a width of 50 pixels for the content. We have a padding of 10, no border, so 0, and then a margin of 20. So the total for that is 110 pixels. You'll notice, though, that the content width is still 50 pixels, even though the total width of all of the stuff together that's going to take up space on your page is 110 pixels.